Welcome, everyone. My name is Tyreek White, and I'm a product manager here at Snapchat. In today's session, my colleague Elliot and I are going to show you how to use the powerful features within My Lenses to improve your lenses and achieve repeatable success on Snapchat. We will cover the standard lens submission flow, including error reporting, community insights from fellow Snapchatters, and event insights to learn how people interact with the individual features within your lens. My Lenses is a tool that features everything from lens submission to error reporting and analytics. It's the primary way to see if your lenses are successful on Snapchat. Now, the most important part of having your lens seen by the Snapchat community is submitting it. So let's start there. Let's walk through the submission flow for a fitness lens I have called Obstacle Challenge. Within Lens Studio, fill out the lens name and select a hint if applicable to your lens. Be sure to also select front camera and rear camera to ensure your lens achieves optimal reach and performance on Snapchat. And when you're finished, click Publish Lens and you'll be directed to My Lenses to finalize your submission. After filling out additional sections and adding categories and relevant tags to your lens, which help increase your lens's visibility on Snapchat, you can click Submit Lens to kick off the lens testing process. Lens submission typically takes minutes to complete. If it takes longer than an hour, reach out to our support team for assistance. When you submit a lens, it goes through multiple testing steps, and if the lens fails submission, we provide error logs. I am super excited to share updates we've recently made to our error logging, and soon, you'll be able to access even more information to improve your lenses. We now provide more visibility into the stages of lens testing, more exposure to different types of lens errors, as well as a new UI to consolidate your logs. While the Obstacle Challenge lens I just submitted goes through the submission flow, I'll show you an example of what a rejection message looks like. You can tell a lens has failed when its status shows as rejected within My Lenses. If we click on My Rejected Lens and explore the logs, we can find more information on why it failed. In this case, I received the following error. Unfortunately, your lens obstacle challenge did not meet our minimum performance requirements during automated testing. Your lens's average active memory usage, or RAM, was 200 megabytes, and the maximum allowed value is 150 megabytes. This error message tells us that one of the assets included in the lens is too large to be distributed on Snapchat. So let's go back to Lens Studio to investigate. In My Lens, I see that it's using multiple texture assets. I need to take a further look into these assets to determine the uncompressed size of each. So to find out more, I'll select each of them in the Resources panel and explore. It looks like I found the source. I can see the RAM usage for some assets is extremely large. Great news! Now, with our new Remote Assets feature, you can use the Lens Cloud service to host larger assets outside of the lens. For this session, however, I'll optimize the texture within my lens and resubmit it, but you can check out the session Leveling Up Your Lenses with Cloud Services on our new Remote Assets feature and see how to use it to lower your lens's RAM usage. And voila, the lens has now passed submission. You will receive an email if there are any errors and when your lens is live on Snapchat, so you always know where in the process your lens is, even if you haven't checked My Lenses. With these latest improvements, you can now see new error messages that you could not before, including the types of devices your lens is failing on, and these new logs also offer more tips about how you should rework your lens to meet submission requirements. Now that your lens is on Snapchat, and you have a better sense of how to use error logs to submit the perfect lens, what comes next? Well, that's the fun part. You can use the analytics within My Lenses to learn more about the audiences that engage with your lenses on Snapchat. You can also use analytics to create repeatable success within your lenses and grow your personal brand over time. Elliot is now going to show you how to get started on your path to success. Happy creating.
Cheers, Tyreek. I'm Elliot Lewis, a software engineer here at Snap. My Lenses can help you take your lenses to the next level by giving you insight into how your lenses perform. Today, we're going to talk about two tools we've recently added to My Lenses. Community Audience can help you find your next audience, and Event Insights will help you better understand users' behavior when they actually use your lens. First, let's talk about Community Audience. We recently launched this tool to help creators understand the demographics of the lens user community while still protecting Snapchatter data and keeping user data private. Imagine I'm a creator based in Paris, building lenses with content in French. I can see breakdowns of anonymized data from across our community outlining the age, country, operating system and device models for our French-speaking Snapchatters who have consented to share. It also shows examples of popular lenses within that audience that you can learn from and find inspiration. This can influence the type of lenses you may choose to design to get the highest reach for your creations. You can use these features to understand the types of devices your target audience uses most, like iOS or Android, so you can build your lens to meet your performance goals across all devices. Let's look back at the fitness lens we showed you earlier. We chose an obstacle course as our first activity because we know how many of our Snap team members regularly talk about their hiking and surfing habits. When we look at the analytics, we can see that our US audience engaged with it the most, but they only make up around 13% of our potential audience. We can see here in community audience the potential increase in engagement with this lens by including popular activities from all over the world. A great place to start would be to include activities popular in India, where there is a potential reach of 155 to 161 million Snapchatters. What activity would you add to this lens to drive engagement within your local community? Let's take a look at Event Insights, another new feature in My Lenses. Event Insights enables you to dive into how Snapchatters interact with your lens, giving you clues about how you can deliver higher quality engagements. Let's look at this gaming lens for an example of how to successfully make changes to your favorite projects. Here, I've created a lens called Cookie Clicker, which is a gaming lens built by the Snapchat team that allows you to collect points as you tap on the cookie. In this lens, you have 5 seconds to collect as many points as possible. I spent a few days creating this lens, and I'm excited about the engagement it will receive on Snapchat. However, when I publish the lens and look at the analytics, only 9.7 tap events are found per lens session, meaning the average user doesn't even end up playing the game as much as we'd like. I noticed this by viewing these analytics in My Lenses after the lens submission. I spoke with some friends and brainstormed a few ideas, including adding additional activities to the lens to get people excited. After thinking about it, I decided to add more interactivity since this is a gaming lens and I want users to feel highly engaged and have fun. Here's the new lens I created and resubmitted. After viewing My Lenses again, we can see the jump in tap events per session. Now we see that users are tapping 18.2 times per session, which means they're really engaging with my game. Event Insights enables you to view actual data on the number of faces found and lost, objects or 3D objects, marker images tracked, screen taps, along with the number of multi-user sessions shared and joined. And all of this information is available by default. So if you use these lens features, you'll be able to see exactly how, when, and where the community interacted with them right in the My Lenses dashboard. We're constantly looking to identify new categories of events we can share with you in Event Insights.
My Lenses' powerful analytics are useful for all of our creator community. Here's what some of our top creators have said about how My Lenses helps them to iterate on their lens success. We check My Lenses statistics on a weekly basis to see performance and specific events that might be triggering some lens due to external trends. We also use it to learn which lenses work better and take that knowledge to improve our branded experience. Augustin Salaberry from Social Snack. Once I publish a lens, I check its analytics in My Lenses twice a week to measure its performance and success. Before publishing the lens, I have a basic pre-campaign strategy in mind, which basically targets and hypothesizes on factors like the target's audience, location, gender, average playtime, and play-to-share ratio. After 2 weeks, I compare the hypothesis with the actual lens insights. From the comparison, I conclude and redefine the hypothesis. Pradeepa Anandi.
To recap what we've covered today, My Lenses is a powerful tool that includes everything you need for submission success and for learning how to build lenses your audience can engage with. My Lenses includes new enhanced error reporting, community audience, and event insights. Community and event insights are generally available today, and error reporting will be available soon. So follow us on Twitter at SnapAR for the latest updates. I encourage you to explore what you can learn about your creations. We can't wait to see your results. Happy creating.